I decided to get one of the TS80P soldering irons that everyone seems to have been raving about for the past year or so. We may be a bit slow on this channel, but hopefully the wait is worthwhile and we do get there in the end. As always, we're sponsored by PCBWay, more about them at the end of the video. The main reason that I wanted to get this soldering iron is because you can easily flash it with open source firmware, which I think is a pretty cool thing to do. Let's try it out with the standard firmware, and then we'll have a go at uploading the open source IronOS software. The first thing to be aware of is that you are going to need a power supply that supports quick charge or power delivery. If you try and use the iron with a normal USB power supply, then it won't work and it will display this nice little error message about the voltage being too low. I've got a couple of USB power supplies that support power delivery. The Apple charger for my laptop, and I've got this nice compact 65 watt gallium nitride fast charger. It looks like gallium nitride is going to become the standard for switching power supplies. It should be a lot more efficient. Unfortunately, I don't actually have any quick charge compatible chargers to test with. Let's try out the Apple one first. I've got it connected up through my USB power monitor. As soon as I click the heating button, we start using almost 9 volts and almost 2 amps. Interestingly, the power reported from my USB power monitor is slightly more than what is reported by the soldering iron. We get up to temperature in just under 20 seconds. Let's try the fast charger. When we click the button, it takes a couple of seconds for it to start using the full 12 volts, but once it gets going, the temperature shoots up. We're up to temperature in 10 seconds. That's pretty amazing. It's twice as fast, which is not that surprising, as we were getting twice as much power, almost 30 watts versus 15 watts. I believe with the Apple charger, the next voltage it supports after 9 volts is 15 volts. The maximum voltage a soldering iron can take is 12 volts, so we are limited to 9 volts if we use the Apple chargers. Flashing with the open source IronOS firmware is really easy. To get the iron into DFU mode, we just hold down the button when connecting it to a USB port on our computer. The device is mounted as a flash drive, and we simply drop the new firmware version into it. If it's successful, then we'll see the file renamed to a new extension RDY. If it fails, then we'll see the extension changed to ERR. If that happens, then just give it another go. There's also some DFU software that you can also drop in, which may improve flashing. But check out the GitHub repository and check out the issues. If you're really stuck, then open an issue. They are very responsive and they seem like really nice guys. What's interesting is that with the new firmware, we can now power the iron off our USB power supply. It does draw around 1 amp though, so you will need a supply that is capable of that. And you'll also need quite a lot of patience, as it does take quite a while. But in an emergency situation where it's all you have, it will probably be okay. But let's move on from this, because it is going to take a while. I've got hold of a Raspberry Pi Pico W, and I'm going to solder on the headers. Let's have a look at how well it works, and I'll try it out. The results are pretty good. I've never been especially good at soldering, which is why I tend to do surface mount nowadays. I've got some new boards to solder up from PCBWay for some future projects, but there's always some through-hole components and headers that are needed. So this soldering iron is going to be a great addition to my toolkit. I'll be replacing my old soldering station with this one. One thing that did catch me out with the Pico W is that the standard LED blink sketch didn't work. You have to use the string LED instead of the number 25. And you need to flash with a nightly build of MicroPython. If you don't, then the sample code doesn't work. This is pretty painless. We just hold down the boot cell button and then drop the new firmware into the USB drive. And we got a flashing LED. Pretty cool. I'll be exploring the Pico W in future projects. Thanks for watching, and here's some information about PCBWay. So, PCBWay, they've been sponsoring the channel for a while now. I've used them for pretty much all my projects. They do all sorts of stuff, CNC, 3D printing. I've got some parts I've actually made with them that I'm going to use in a future project, so stay tuned, because it's going to be pretty exciting.